Yamunatiravanachari
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 Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari Gopi Jana Bala Bhagiri Bharata Bala Bhakri Bharadhari Yashoda Nandana Praja Janarandana Yashoda Nandana Praja Janarandana Yamuna Tira Vanachari Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Rama Rama Hare Hare Vishnupad Paramahansa Parivrajakacharya Ashtatara Satta Shri Srimad His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ki Viscon Founder Acharya Srila Prabhupada Ki Nitya Lila Pravishta Om Vishnupad Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasati Thakur Srila Prabhupada Ki Ananta Koti Vaishnavrinda Ki Nam Acharya Srila Haridas Thakur Ki Premshigo Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Ki Shri Shri Radha Krishna Gopa Gopina Shyam Kun Radha Kun Giri Govardhan Ki Vrindavan Mayapurdam Ki Ganga Maye Yamuna Maye Ki Tosi Maharani Bhakti Devi Ki Yuga Dharma Harinam Sankirtan Ki All glories to assembled devotees. All glories to assembled devotees. All glories assembled devotees. All glories Sri Guru Sri Gauranga. All glories Srila Prabhupada. Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Iti Namane Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Desha Tarini Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya
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 Narayanam Namaskrityam
Narayanam Namaskrityam
Naram Chaiva Narottamam
Naram Chaiva Narottamam
Devim Sarasatim Vyasam
Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam
Tato Jayamudiraya
Tato Jayamudiraya
Nasta Praeshu Vabhadreshu
Nasta Praeshu Vabhadreshu
Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya
Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya
Bhagavati Uttama Shloke
Bhagavati Uttama Shloke
Bhakti Bhavati Naishtaki
Bhakti Bhavati Naishtaki
So now we're nearing the end of the year.
马上快到年底了。
end of another year, into a new year.
现在是一年的结束，要进入新的一年。
We know, as every year, there's more and more obstacles.
我们知道一年的困难比一年多。
We're seeing some unexpected obstacles.
我们看到了一些没有意料到的障碍和困难。
Just like this pandemic situation, nobody could ever have imagined it would happen.
就像这个疫情，没有人曾经想象过会有这样的事情发生。
And we also don't know what is actually going to happen in the new year with our internet connections and our links with our fellow devotees in China.
而且我们也不知道在国内对于他们的这些互联网的链接会发生什么。
With new laws, legislation, we don't know what will be the obstacles.
新的法律和规定，
所以我们不知道会有什么样的困难。
But we have to expect that there will be obstacles. It's the nature of the material world.
但是我们应该意料到就会有困难，这是物质世界的本性。
Srila Prabhupada wrote in the Chaitanya Charitamrita how our movement faced many obstacles in the beginning.
薛勒帕帕在《查坦涅查尔塔米特》中提到，我们的运动在开始的时候就面临很多的困难。
And he pointed out how, even in the times of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, there were obstacles, there were threats from the Mohammedan government.
而且他指出，就在主查坦涅马哈普布的那个时代，也有困难，有来自于穆罕默德穆斯林政府的威胁。
The Chankasi coming and breaking the Madanga at the home of Srivas Thakur.
有 Chankasi 来到了 Srivas Thakur 的家，把他的 Madanga 鼓打破了。
And telling them no more kirtan.
而且告诉他们不许再做 kirtan 了。
And so Srila Prabhupada talked about how our devotees in countries like Australia were harassed a lot in their attempts to distribute Prabhupada's books.
而且施乐帕帕告诉我们，像在澳大利亚这样的国家，当大家要去派发施乐帕帕德的书籍的时候，受到了很多的骚扰。
Sometimes devotees would be taken and arrested and put into jail for some time.
有的时候，奉献者们会被捕，并且被关进监狱里一段时间。
But now they have a very nice relationship, and everyone has a good respect for Krishna consciousness in Australia.
但是现在在澳大利亚，他们有非常好的关系，每一个人都非常的尊重奉献者。
Devotees are, they have established very nice centers and they have wonderful restaurants.
奉献者们确立了非常好的中心，还有餐厅。
And everyone knows Hare Krishna have nice food.
而且每一个人都知道 Hare Krishna 有非常棒的食物。
They may not all appreciate our philosophy, but at least they appreciate our food.
他们可能并不都欣赏我们的哲学，但是他们至少全都欣赏我们的食物。
So, you know, that's one way to reach people. They say the way to a man is through his tongue, through the heart, or through the tongue.
这是管理的一种办法，就是想要征服一个男人的话，应该先征服他的舌头。
So if you can satisfy a man with good food, then it's a very good start to having a nice relationship.
你可以用好的食物来满足一个人，这样你就可以很好的发展跟他的关系。
And we see it throughout the world, different parts of the world, devotees had many obstacles. In Russia, there was a lot of difficulties to begin Krishna consciousness there.
我们可以看到在世界上的其他国家，比如说在俄罗斯，奉献者们在那个地方，他们开展这种活动也非常有困难。
The devotees had to smuggle the books in, and many different devotees were persecuted.
奉献者们必须要把书籍通过走私的方式运进国内，然后很多的奉献者都受到了迫害。
And even some people died. They gave up their lives.
甚至有的人死去，他们放弃了自己的生命。
But now, Krishna consciousness movement is established throughout Russia, in many parts of Russia.
但是现在 Krishna 知觉已经在俄罗斯确立了起来，在俄罗斯的大部分全都建立完整的体系。
And even there was an attempt to ban the Bhagavad Gita. They said the Bhagavad Gita is not a proper book. We don't want to print this book in our country, in Russia. And they wanted to ban the Bhagavad Gita.
曾经一度他们想禁止 Bhagavad Gita. 他们说这个 Bhagavad Gita 不是一本恰当的书籍，所以我们不允许在这个国家印刷并且派发这本书。
But the devotees had their own legal defense, and they went to the courts, and they got support from other countries around the world, and they were successful, and the Bhagavad Gita was recognized as a proper book, a religious book.
但是奉献者们采取了法律的辩护措施，他们上了法庭，而且得到了其他国家的奉献者们的支持，终于 Bhagavad Gita 作为一个合法的书籍得到了承认。
It's an authorized book. It's been, it was spoke, written by Ganesh from the words of Srila Vyasadeva 5,000 years ago at the beginning of the Kali Yuga.
这个其实是一本授权的书籍，是由 Ganesh 通过 Vyasadeva 的口述写出来的。这是在五千年之前 Kali Yuga 的开始成书的。
And it was brought to the Western world more than a couple of hundred years ago.
而且是在两百多年之前被带到了西方国家。
And there were many great scholars and philosophers who all spoke about the Bhagavad Gita.
很多伟大的哲学家、思想家，他们都谈论过。还有像爱默生以及梭罗这样在西方世界非常享誉盛名的哲学家。
And of course, in India, Mahatma Gandhi, he also carried the Bhagavad Gita with him everywhere.
当然还有在印度像 Mahatma Gandhi 圣雄甘地这样的人，他无论去什么地方都会随身携带一本 Bhagavad Gita。
So Bhagavad Gita was recognized that there's nothing wrong with this book. It's a very good book.
所以 Bhagavad Gita 是一本受到公认的书籍，这是一本非常好的书，没有任何的问题。
So of course you have to expect there will be difficulties, there will be opposition in trying to spread Krishna consciousness.
大家一定要意料到在传播 Krishna 知觉的过程之中会出现一些困难。
Not everyone wants to accept the knowledge of Krishna consciousness and the fact that we're not the bodies, that we're spirit souls.
并不是每一个人都愿意接受 Krishna 知觉的这个知识，我们不是这个躯体，我们是灵魂。
So we're preaching to very misguided people. The world is controlled by their mind and senses, and they don't think about higher purposes in life.
我们在向那些被误导的人去给他们宣讲，因为他们受到自己的心理和感官的控制，并不了解人生的使命到底是什么。
They're all just mad for sense gratification, which means satisfying the tongue and filling the belly.And then satisfying the genital.
他们疯狂地追求感官享乐，兴趣只在于满足自己的舌头，填饱自己的肚腹，并且满足自己的生殖器。
And we see smoking and drinking, as well as gambling and intoxication, is everywhere.
我们可以看到，大家在抽烟、喝酒、赌博、服用麻醉品，无处不在。
One of our devotees in China.Is a lawyer, and he told me that most of his clients, he's working to help their children with drug cases that they're involved in. You know, they've been caught with drugs or something, and they have cases against them. So he tries to help them to get a, you know, to get off or to get a light sentence.
那么我在国内有一个奉献者，他说他的工作就是帮助那些因为the drug dealers.They're dealing with drugs.
Yeah, they're taking drugs or dealing with drugs.
那些贩毒的人，他帮助他们进行辩护，帮他们去解决自己的法律的问题。
And so China, we never thought these things would come into China. China is a very, sophisticated, you know, conservative country where people live nice lives. Where we never thought things like drugs would come into the society there.
因为我们一直会觉得中国是一个保守的国家。我们从来没有想到过毒品这样的东西都会进入这样的地方，在社团之中传播。
In Western countries like USA, of course, these things are there because people are so crazy anyway.
在西方国家，比如说像美国，会有这样的事情发生，因为无论如何，他们已经是很疯狂了。
But we're seeing these evils spreading all over the world in every part of the globe.
但是现在我们可以看到，这种邪恶传遍了全世界的每一个角落。
And in the same way, we want to spread Krishna consciousness everywhere.
同样道理，我们也想把 Krishna 知觉传遍所有的地方。
We want to introduce the message of Krishna. As Lord Chaitanya said, "Nagar adigram in every town, in every village."
我们想传播 Krishna 的讯息。主 Chaitanya 说 ，"Nagar adigram 在每一个城镇和乡村。
The holy name should be chanted. Who's going to go there? People have to go there and do it.
圣名应该在每一个城镇和乡村被大家所唱诵，但是谁能这么做呢？应该有人去做。
Lord Chaitanya told Lord Nityananda, "Don't come back to Jagannath Puri next year. Just you stay in Bengal and preach."
主柴坦尼告诉主尼天南的，你不要每一年都来加格纳普瑞，你应该待在孟加拉，并且去传播。
Lord Nityananda was coming with all the devotees. He'd come all the way from Mayapur to Jagannath Puri, walking and spend their Rathi, have the Rathi Yatra there, and then spend Chaturmasya there, and they would enjoy the association of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
主尼天南的会带着马雅普的奉献者们长途跋涉，一路前往加格纳普瑞。他们先庆祝 Ratha Yatra 弹车节，然后经历四月苦行的这个雨季 Chaturmasya， 所以他们非常的享受主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的涟漪。
And we can read about these pastimes in the Chaitanya Charitamrita.
我们可以在 Chaitanya Charitamrita 上读到这些逍遥时光。
And we see how sweet the loving dealings were, and how Lord Chaitanya enjoyed their company, and of course they were all in ecstasy being with Lord Chaitanya.
我们可以看到他们的交往是多么的甜美，主柴坦涅多么享受跟他们在一起的联谊，而且他们跟主柴坦涅在一起度过了多少甜美的逍遥时光。
Lord Chaitanya would ask, where is that Murari Gupta? There'd be so many devotees, there'd be so many devotees around Lord Chaitanya, and Lord Chaitanya would be remembering some of his intimate associates, and he would ask, where's Murari Gupta?
主柴坦涅身边会聚集着很多的奉献者，他有时候会想起他的一些亲密同游，于是有的时候他就会问到 Murari Gupta 在哪儿。
Murari Gupta is very humble. He doesn't like to even go near Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He's way in the back, way outside.
Murari Gupta 非常的谦卑，他不愿意甚至来到主柴坦涅马哈帕布的跟前，他在很远很远外边的地方。
Just like Mathura Lila's husband.
就像是 Mathura Lila 的丈夫一样。
He doesn't come in the temple, he sits outside.
他不到庙里来，他在外面。
Oh, he's here today.
哦，在这儿了。
So Murari Gupta would be in the back and then he would come forward.
所以 Murari Gupta 本来在后面，现在他就到前面来。
And Lord Chaitanya would give him a garland or praise him, talk aboutpastimes which happened long ago.
主柴坦涅就会给他一串花环，然后呢，跟他谈论在很久以前发生的那些逍遥时光，并且赞美他。
Because Murari Gupta had watched Lord Chaitanya grow up from his childhood, he'd seen all the childhood lila.
因为 Murari Gupta 他是看着主柴坦涅从小长大的，他见证了主柴坦涅所有孩提时代的逍遥时光。
But anyway, Lord Chaitanya told Lord Nityananda.Don't come next year. Just you stay in Bengal and preach.
但是主柴坦涅告诉主尼天南的，你不要每一年都来，你就待在孟加拉去传播吧。
And similarly, there was a devotee. He was a sannyasi. He was staying in Vrindavan, and he took when Prabhupada came to Vrindavan, he told Prabhupada, said Prabhupada, I just want to stay here in Vrindavan.
同样道理，有一个奉献者，他是sannyasi，他住在文达文，他告诉舍勒帕帕说。我只想待在文达文。
But Prabhupada told him, he said, "Your duty is to give Vrindavan to others."
但是帕帕告诉他说，你的职责是把文达文给其他的人。
You should go travel, preach.
你应该去旅行传播。
Just like just now, His Holiness Jayapataka Swami Maharaj, he's anxious to go and travel.
就像现在圣座迦帕塔克斯瓦米马哈拉吉，他非常迫切的想去旅行。
But his doctors are all saying, "No, no, no, no. you stay here.
但是所有他的医生们都说不不不不不，你就待在这里。
And they're all telling him it's not a good idea to go out traveling now.
他们都告诉他说现在出去旅行不是一个好主意。
Now of course there's this variant of the COVID which is coming from South Africa which is going everywhere. So people are all very afraid for this.
现在有一种从南非传过来的新冠的变体，大家都非常的害怕。
So they're trying. There's so many restrictions on traveling wherever you go.
所以无论你去哪儿旅行的话，都会有很多的限制。
It's not a time to travel. You can go. Stay.
现在还不是旅行的时候，最好还是待在家。
Just like some people, you know, they come.Come to Mayapur, they plan to stay. One devotee came the other day from Malaysia. He said, I came on a one-way ticket.
就像现在有一些奉献者，他们想住在马来普，留在马来普。有一个奉献者，他从马来西亚来，他说，我的这个票是一个礼拜的票。1 week's ticket.
No, one way.
Oh, one, I'm sorry. 是单程票。
Yeah.Yeah, one way, he came with a one-way ticket. Means he's not planning, doesn't know when he'll go back.
他这个单程票的意思就是说他没计划着要回去。
So, that's very nice, just like all of you.
就非常好，就像你们所有的人一样。
We're all here, we don't know when we can go back.
我们全都在这里，我们不知道什么时候才能回去。
But it's not a big problem.
但这并不是一个大问题。
We're in the best place.
我们在最好的地方。
We're the most fortunate.
我们是最幸运的人。
Everyone else is envying us.
所有其他的人都在嫉妒我们。
They're all going, oh, I wish I had come to Mayapur.
其他人都在哭，哦，我希望我能来马来普就好了。
So, of course, sometimes when we get here, some people think, I want to go to Mayapur.
但有的时候人们来了之后就说哦，我想走，我想走了。
Anyway, everybody has their own will. It's up to Krishna.
但无论如何，每个人都有自己的意愿，最后要取决于 Krishna.
Krishna's a controller. We're simply instruments.
Krishna 是控制者，我们只不过是工具。
We have to let Krishna take, just manage whatever he thinks is right for us.
我们要让 Krishna 来管理，无论他觉得对于我们来讲什么是最好的，就听他的安排。
Wherever we go, the main thing is to remember Krishna.
无论我们去什么样的地方，最主要的事情是应该记住 Krishna.
If we forget Krishna, then wherever you go is useless.
如果我们忘记了 Krishna, 无论去什么地方都是没有用处的。
Even if you go to the heavenly planets, if you're not Krishna conscious, if you're forgetting Krishna, it will just be hell.
如果你去天堂星球，如果你没有记得 Krishna， 把 Krishna 给忘了的话，那就是相当于像去了地狱一样。
But even if we're in hell, if we may think, but this is hell here. I want to. But if we're Krishna conscious, that's very good.
但如果我们身处地狱之中，我们有 Krishna 知觉，那也是一件非常好的事情。
So we're coming up to the New Year. There's a custom that we have in the Western countries.I don't think you do it in China, but in the Western countries, they talk about New Year resolutions.
马上就要过新年了，我不知道在中国你们是不是做这个，但是在西方一般我们都会说要下一个新年的决心。
Yeah, you make a, you know, a kind of vow that, you know, in the New Year, I'm going to do this, you know, I'm going to make a vow to do this.
你去发誓，过新年了，我要发誓，我要去做这件事情。
I'm only going to eat prasadam.
我将只吃 prasadam.
I'm not going to eat any more boga.
我再也不会吃更多的 boga 了。
Right?
可以吗
？I'm only going to chant at least 16 rounds of Hare Krishna mantra.
我将唱诵至少16圈 Hare Krishna Maha mantra.
We make a promise to Krishna that for the new year I'm going to be a good devotee.
我们向 Krishna 许下诺言，在新年里我将成为一个好奉献者。
I'm going to go and see the deities every day.
我将每天去看神像。
I'm going to chant the Mangalarti.
我要去参加 Mangalarti.
I'm going to worship Tulsi.
我要去崇拜 Tulsi.
I'm going to pray to Krishna.
我要向 Krishna 祈祷。
I want to remember Krishna constantly.
我想不断地忆念 Krishna.
Of course, somebody may think, well, I'm already perfect. I don't need to make any resolutions.
有的时候我们会认为，哦，我已经很完美了，我不需要再下任何的决心了。
Okay, you're very great soul. You're perfect.
好吧，你是一个伟大的灵魂，你已经完美了。
But for the rest of us, I don't know about you, but I know myself. I need to make some resolutions. I need to try to do more. Try to be a better devotee.
我不知道你，但是对于我们其他的人来讲，我是了解我自己的。我觉得我需要下一个决心，我需要成为一个更好的奉献者。
I want to study Prabhupada's books better.
我想更好的去学习帕布帕德的书。
So being here in Mayapur and here in the Mayapur Institute, it's a very great opportunity for us to hear and chant and to advance in Krishna consciousness.
身处马耶普，尤其是在马耶普学院里，这是一个很好的机会。我们应该努力的聆听唱诵，并且学习经典。
So many, so many devotees from other countries, they're trying to get here. They want to come here. They want to bring their children here to get education in Mayapur.
有很多其他国家的奉献者们，他们都想到这里来，想把自己的孩子也带来，在马耶普接受教育。
We've got the most wonderful schools here for the children to get educated.
这里有对于孩子们来说最好的学校，可以让他们受到教育。
Could never get that opportunity outside. You go outside in the government schools outside, you know, away from the holy dharma, very different places.
在外面不可能得到这样的机会。如果你们在外面去那些政府开办的学校，永远。不会有这样的机会。
But the schools here in Mayapur are very wonderful. They get the young people, they get very good education, very nice opportunity.
但是在这里，在 Mayapur, 这些小孩们他们都可以得到很好的机会，受到教育。
You could never equal the education in any other place.
永远不可能把这个地方的教育跟其他任何地方相提并论。
And here, also in Mayapur, we get the best deity worship.
而且在 Mayapur, 我们有最好的神像崇拜。
You can see our beautiful deities, Radha Madhava, Astasaki, Panchatattva, Lord Nrisingadev. So wonderful, so big and gorgeous, and so beautifully worshipped.
我们可以看到美丽的 Shri Radha Madhava, Shri Panchatattva, Prahlada Nrisingadev, 非常美丽的被装饰，并且得到很好的崇拜。
Of course, we suffered a great loss last year, or this year, it was this year, when His Grace Pankajangari Prabhu left the world.
当然我们遭受了一个巨大的损失，那就是今年尊敬的 Pankajangari Prabhu 离开了这个世界。
And Pankajangari Prabhu was in charge of the deity department.
Pankajangari Prabhu 掌管神像崇拜部门。
He was always on the Nrisingadev altar there, serving Lord Nrisingadev.
他一直在主女星的 Dev 的神坛上去服务主女星的 Dev。
Sikhi Mahiti Prabhu, he said, well, Janani Vas, he's up. He's up there on the altar with Radha Madhava, Astasaki, it's way up above everyone. But Pankajangari Prabhu was serving Lord Nrisingadev. He was down there with all the devotees.
Sikhi Mahiti Prabhu 说 Janani Vas Prabhu, 他是高高在上的，他在每一个人的上面在服务 Radha Madhava 和 Astasaki 们，但是圣 Pankajangari Prabhu 他是在下面，他在服务主女星的 Dev。
So being down there, he was more exposed to all the people coming to the temple and all the, and that's maybe why he got affected by the COVID, but Janani Vas Prabhu didn't.
在下面就意味着他会更多的暴露给这些来访的人流，所以他可能就因此接触到了病毒，而Janani Vas Prabhu就没有得这个病。
But we're certainly lucky that Janani Vas Prabhu is still with us, but it was a great loss to lose Pankajangari.
我们当然非常的幸运，还有Janani Vas Prabhu跟我们在一起，但是呢，巨大的损失是我们失去了Pankajangari Prabhu.
He was a very, very special devotee.And he did wonderful service.
他是一位非常非常特殊的奉献者，而且他做出了很奇妙的服务。
He wrote the book about the pastimes of Lord Jagannath, and then also about the pastimes of Lord Nrisingadev.
他写了两本书，一本是关于主加格纳特的逍遥时光，还有一本是关于主女星的 Dev 的逍遥时光。
And he was really the inspiration behind the whole deity worship program here in Mayapur.
他 真的是在马亚普这个地方整个的神像崇拜节目的灵感的来源。
And he would go and travel as well. He'd go around different parts of the world and he would get donations and bring the money back to serve the deities here in Mayapur.
而且他还会出去在各个不同的地方旅行，收集的钱他都会带回来服务马亚普的神像。
He spent his whole life practically. He came here. Well, he joined the movement in London in 1973 and then he came here to Mayapur quite early.
他把一生都献给了马亚普，他是在1973年的时候在伦敦加入的 Krishna 知觉，很快他便来到了马亚普。
And stayed here with his brother for nearly 50 years.
在这里跟他的哥哥一起住了几乎五十年。
And we can see the results. Just like when you go somewhere, and if you can stay somewhere, then you can do something.
我们可以看到这个结果，如果你去一个地方，你待在那儿，你可以做成一些事情。
Right, but if you just go and travel around, you never achieve anything.
但如果你只是到处的去旅行，你不能达成任何的事情。
We have a saying in the English language: "A rolling stone gathers no moss."
我们在英文之中有一句谚语：“滚动的石头不会长苔藓。”
Yeah, you have a rolling stone, just rolling. You don't gather any moss. So, but if you stay in one place, then You get things growing around it, the weeds all grow up around it and everything.
因为这个石头一直在不停地滚动，所以它上面什么也长不了，不会长苔藓。但如果待在一个地方，周围就会长一些东西，不过杂草也会长出来。
So the same way, if you stay in one place and you develop something, then you get, you know, you get a group of people and you make a nice center and you get deities and you actually establish something.
如果你待在一个地方不动的话，你就可以发展出一个中心，你周围有一些人，你可以确立神像，这样的话你可以设立一些东西。
So Srila Prabhupada was concerned that when he was departing from the world, he was very much concerned that the movement would continue.
Srila Prabhupada 很担心的一件事情就是当他离开躯体之后，这个运动是否还能够继续发展下去。
He said, we've taken so much trouble to begin the movement, it should go on.
因为我们花了很多的力气来开始这个运动，它应该继续不断地发展下去。
We hope it will go on for many, many, many years.
我们希望它能够继续不断地发展很多很多年。
Just like we see temples in South India, as well as some in North India, they've been there for 1,000 years.
就像我们看到在南印度或者是北印度，有一些庙宇已经存在了上千年之久。
Jagannath Puri Temple is at least 1,000 years old.
加格纳斯普瑞的庙就有1000多年的历史。
And Tirupati Balaji is also very, very ancient, more than 1,000 years old.
Tirupati Balaji 的庙宇甚至超过了1000年。
And then Sri Rangam, Lord Ranganath, that's also very, very ancient deity.
还有 Sri Ranga, 主 Ranganath 也是非常古老的神像。
Some of these deities are from the previous yuga.
有一些神像来自于上一个 yuga。
So, Vrindavan, you know, many of the deities there, they were lost. And it was when the Goswamis like Rupa and Sanatan came there, they found these deities. They had been lost, and they found them and then established temples for them.
在 Vrindavan, 很多的神像都失落了，而 Rupa, Sanatan, Goswami 他们去了之后，发掘出来了这些神像，并且呢，设立了对他们的崇拜，设立了庙宇。
Like Sanatan Goswami, he found the deity of Madan Mohan.
就像 Sanatan Goswami, 他找到了 Madan Mohan 的神像。
It was in some man's house. The man was worshipping. He had the deity, and he was treating the deity like it was his son.
是在一个人的家里，虽然这是一尊神像，但是那个人对待这个神像就像对待自己的儿子一样。
The man was actually an advanced devotee. He had that relationship with Krishna, but Salya Ra said he was thinking of himself like Krishna's father, and the deity was his son. So he was talking to the deity, sometimes chastising the deity.
这个人实际上是一个非常精进的奉献者，他跟神像之间有 Vatsalya Ras 的这种父母之爱的情感，所以他认为自己是神像的父母，而神像是他的孩子，所以有的时候他会跟神像说话，甚至是责怪神像。
But anyway, Sanatana Goswami, was able to get the deity from that man, and he established that beautiful Madan Mohan temple.
但无论如何，萨纳坦·戈斯瓦米从这个人那里得到了这尊神像，而且确立了美丽的马丹摩汉的神庙。
And he didn't have any money. He came there with no money, but Krishna arranged a man to come there to give them to build the temple for him.
他没有任何的钱，而 Krishna 安排有一个人给了他所有的钱，以便于他可以设立这座美丽的庙宇。
In the same way, Rupa Goswami, he got the Govinda Ji deity.Which was also from the time after, just after Krishna had left the world, one of the deities worshipped by Krishna's grandson.
Vrajanath.
So Krishna's grandson, he established many deities of Lord Krishna.
同样道理 Rupa Goswami 他发掘到了 Govinda Ji 的神像，这个神像是在 Krishna 离开这个地球之后由他的曾孙所设立崇拜的神像。
And these deities were gradually discovered by the associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
这些神像逐渐地被主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的同游发掘了出来。
And this is how we have these nice temples, the principal temples there.In Vrindavan.
这是我们如何得到了在 Vrindavan 的主要的神庙。
So there are many deities. We hope our deity worship will go on, continue.
有很多的神像，我们希望我们的神像崇拜将继续不断地进行下去。
There was a nice lady came from England. Her name was Rama Devi, and she was making dresses for the deities here.
有一个奉献者非常好，来自于英国，他的名字叫 Rama Devi， 他为神像做非常漂亮的衣服。
And she also left her body last year.
去年他也离开了躯体。
She had some cancer and she gave up her body. That was just before Pankajangri left the body. She departed.
他得了癌症，应该就是在 Pankajangri Prabhu 离开躯体之前，他离开了他的躯体。
But she made some very, very, very beautiful night dresses.For Radhamadava Astasakis.
他为 Radhamadava 还有 Astasaki 们做了非常非常漂亮的睡衣。
Right? If you go to Mongol Arti, you can see the deities wearing some of these different dresses, and they're very beautiful dresses.
你去参加 Mongol Arti 就会发现神像穿着一些这样的衣服，非常非常美丽的衣服。
So this is devotional service. This is using your skill, whatever talent you have.You use it for the service of Krishna.
这就是奉献服务。无论你有什么样的技巧，你的才华都可以用于去服务 Krishna.
Somebody's a good cook. Cook for Krishna.
有的人是一个很好的厨师，那就为 Krishna 做饭吧。
When was it? Who had a birthday the other day? They made a birthday cake. Make a birthday cake for someone.
有谁那天过生日来着，做了一个蛋糕，生日蛋糕。
It's devotional service.
这也是奉献服务。
When somebody else is kirtan, they do kirtan for Krishna.
其他的人他们的特长是 kirtan, 他们可以为 Krishna 做 kirtan.
And somebody else is a book distributor, distribute books for Krishna.
而另外的人他们是一个派书的奉献者，可以为 Krishna 而派发书籍。
And of course, the devotees, they're still in the marathon consciousness. They're still thinking.How to distribute books because the marathon is going until the 15th of January, I think.
奉献者们现在还处在马拉松的知觉状态之中，因为大家还在想着怎么去派发更多的书籍。我想这个马拉松应该是一直到1月15号。
For Krishna is pleased with the devotion. It's not what you do, but it's how you do it.
Krishna 被你的奉爱之情所打动，不是说你做什么，而是说你怎么做。
That we must do it with.Devotion.
我们必须要满怀奉爱之情的去做。
Maybe you're a businessman. You can make a lot of money for Krishna.
可能你是一个做生意的人，可以为 Krishna 挣很多的钱。
Marichi Prabhu is a great businessman.
Marichi Prabhu 就是一个很棒的生意人。
He's retired now. He's come to Mayapur.
他现在退休了，来到了 Mayapur.
You can see all his gray hair.
可以看到他的满头的灰发。
He's come to retire in Mayapur.
他来 Mayapur 退休。
But Marichi Prabhu does great service for Krishna every year.
但是 Marichi Prabhu 每一年都为 Krishna 做出很伟大的服务。
He organizes the safari which the devotees go on every year. After the Gaur Purnima, the devotees go for safari.
他为奉献者们安排 safari， 每一年 Gaur Purnima 之后，他都安排奉献者们参加这个 safari 的节目。
And for many many years, Marichi Prabhu has been doing this.
而且很多很多年 Marichi Prabhu 都在做这个
taking the devotees along with His Holiness Jayapataka Swami Maharaj and often also who is that African sannyasi?
Bhaktivira Damodar Maharaj.
Bhaktivira Damodar Maharaj also likes to go on the safari and many devotees from different countries they all go on this safari to visit the different places and Marichi Prabhu organizes.
Marichi Prabhu 每一年都会带着奉献者们以及圣座加帕塔克斯瓦米马哈拉吉还有非洲的一位马哈拉吉 Bhakti Dira Damodar Maharaj 一起去参加这个活动、
So if you get the chance if we have the chance this year I don't know coming year if we have the chance or not we have to see how the COVID situation is but if you get the opportunity it's very nice to go out on the safari
如果有机会的话，我不知道来年是不是我们能够有机会，不知道这个新冠疫情的这个情况怎么样。如果能够去参加 Safari， 会非常荣幸的一件事情。
Lord Chaitanya's movement is like that. It's for moving, for traveling. We don't. Lord Chaitanya himself, he traveled for 6 years around India, visiting all the holy places.
主柴坦尼马哈波布的这个运动就是一个。这样的运动，朱柴坦尼马哈帕布本人在花了6年的时间在南印度旅行。
Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes in his Vaishnava song, "May I always visit all the holy places associated with the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu."
Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur 在他的《奉爱的歌曲》之中写道：“愿我能够一直去拜访所有这些跟朱柴坦尼马哈帕布逍遥时光有关的圣地。”
Of course, all the holy places are here in Mayapur Dham.
当然了，所有的圣地都在 Mayapur Dham 这里。
So you just go around Mayapur Dham, you can see all the holy places.
只要你转遍整个的 Mayapur Dham, 你就可以看到所有的圣地。
One time, Gorkishore Das Babaji Maharaj had eyesight problem.So Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati Prabhupada wanted to take him to Calcutta to get some medical treatment for his eyes.
有一次 Gorkishore Das Babaji Maharaj 得了一种眼的疾病然后 Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur 想带他去加尔各答治疗他的眼疾。
But he said, I will not go to Calcutta. I will not go to the material world.
但是他说我不要去加尔各答我不要去物质世界。
Understand.He knew Mayapur is not the material world. This is the spiritual world.
要知道，他明白 Mayapur 不是物质世界，这就是灵性世界。
We're here in the spiritual world.
我们在这里，在灵性世界。
We're so fortunate.
我们是如此的幸运。
We just have to appreciate the holy Dham.
我们只需要去欣赏神圣的 Dham.
Just like we were talking about who's actually a Brijbasi. There are many people in Vrindavan.They don't appear to be very Krishna conscious.
就像有的时候我们会讨论到底谁是一位真正的 Vrajbasi 就是 Vrindavan 的居民在 Vrindavan 有很多的人但是他们的知觉并不是都是非常提升的
They don't actually see the holy Dham.
他们并没有实际的看到神圣的 Dham.
The holy Dham is covered to them.
神圣的 Dham 对于他们来讲是覆盖的
The actual Vrajbasi people, the real Vrajbasis,They will chant the holy name of Krishna. They will hear the glories of Krishna with love and devotion.
真正的 Vrajabasi, Vrindavan 的居民，他们会满怀奉爱之心的去唱诵 Krishna 的圣名。
So it's not just taking birth in the holy place, and it's not just buying a ticket that you come to the holy place.
并不仅仅是出生在圣地的问题，并不仅仅是买一张票你就可以到达圣地。
We have to understand what is the holy Dham.
我们必须要明白神圣的 Dham 到底是什么。
It's the place where the Lord resides eternally.
这是一个主永恒的居住的地方。
Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu resides here in this holy Dham eternally.
主柴坦尼马哈普布永恒地居住在这个神圣的 Dham.
Are you seeing him?
你们看到他了吗？
Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati Prabhupada would go out in the night. he would meet the Sankirtan party, he would meet Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and all the devotees having Nagar Kirtan.
去了 Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, 他半夜的时候会出去，他会去见所有的这些 Sankirtan 的队伍的奉献者们，他会去见主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
They're here, we just have to purify our consciousness and we can see.
他们都在这里，我们只需要净化我们的知觉，我们便可以看到他们。
So we have to purify. How do we purify? That's hearing and chanting, doing good sadhana.
我们应该得到净化，怎么才能得到净化呢？我们应该聆听、唱诵，做好我们的 sadhana.
Right, but come here to do, this is the best opportunity we'll ever get in our life to do sadhana.
这是我们一辈子之中能够得到的最好的做 sadhana 的机会。
We could never get a better opportunity to do better sadhana than here in Mayapur at this time.
我们永远也不会像现在这样在 Mayapur 这里做这么好的 sadhana 了。
And by sadhana, one day we will become siddha.
通过 sadhana, 终有一天我们成为 siddha.
Just now we're sadhakas, we're not perfect.
现在我们是 sadhaka, 我们并不完美。
But when we become perfect, then you become siddha.
但是当我们达到完美的时候，我们成为 siddha.
So, 我们查得远。
我们查得远。
We have a long way to go.
我们还有很长的路要走。
But well, we have to be very eager, very enthusiastic, determined.
但是我们必须要非常的迫切，非常的有决心。
Okay, any question?
有什么问题吗？
Yes, Charu Chitra.
What's the meaning of Sita?
Perfection.
Perfection. We become Sita.
Siddhi.
Siddhi.
S-I-D-D-H-I.
S-I-D-D-H-A,
Siddhi. Or Siddha, S-I-D-D-H-A, the person, but Siddhi. Yeah, perfection means you're perfect. Your sadhana is already perfect. You've done all the sadhana and you've come to the perfect stage where you have developed Krishna consciousness fully. You're fully Krishna conscious.
Siddhi 是完美 ，Sita 是一个得到了完美的人，也就是说，你完全的发展出了你的 Krishna 知觉，你在全面的 Krishna 知觉之中，这是一种完美的状况。
Often we talk about the Ashta Siddhis, which are the eight perfections you get by practicing mystic yoga.
我们经常谈论 Ashta Siddhi, 也就是通过修习玄秘瑜伽得到的八种瑜伽的完美。
Where you can become lighter than the lightest.
你可以变得比最轻的还轻。
Or you may become heavier than the heaviest.
或者比最重的还重。
Or you become, you can take things from very far away.
或者是从很远的地方把东西拿来。
That's Prapta Siddhi.
这个叫 Prapta Siddhi.
So Lagima Siddhi, Mahima Siddhi, different cities, perfections. There are eight different kinds of perfections which the yogis achieve, mystic powers.
有 Lagima City, Mahima City, 也就是这些修习玄秘瑜伽的瑜伽师们，他们可以得到八种瑜伽的玄秘力量。
So the Bhakti Yogi, they should also have these cities.
Bhakti Yogi, 奉爱瑜伽师也会有这些 city.
If he's come to the Siddha stage, if he's perfect, then he will also have these cities.
如果他达到了 Siddha 的这种阶段，达到完美的阶段，他也会拥有所有这些玄秘的力量。
But he won't use them.
但他根本不会用它们。
Because he knows.Just attract materialistic people.
因为他知道这只会吸引那些物质主义者。
Sometimes people would ask Prabhupada about that. Have you got this? What is your city? Where is your perfection? Show us your. Can you show us some of your perfection? Your city.
有的时候人们就会问 Srila Prabhupada, 你的完美的这种玄秘的力量在哪里？能不能给我们展示一下你的 city?
And Prabhupada would say, yes, you see all these people? He said they were all hippies, they were all drug addicts and womanizers and meat eaters and everything. They had all bad habits. Now they're very saintly. He said, that is my city. I changed them.
Srila Prabhupada 就会说你看到这些人了吗他们以前是嬉皮士他们吸毒他们吃肉他们追求女人但是现在他们已经改变了他们都成为了圣洁的人。所以是我改变了他们，这就是我的 city。
S-I-D-D-H-I. Siddhi. Yes. But we are sadhakas, we're not siddhis.
但是我们是 sadhaka 们，我们还不是 siddhi 们。
Siddhi is the goal.
Siddhi 是目标。
To come to that perfect stage.
达到那种完美的层面。
Mm-hmm. Who else had a question?
还有谁有问题？You mentioned that I have a lot of obstacles in my spiritual practice. We always say that without Krishna's permission, even a blade of grass cannot move. That means all the obstacles confronted in front of the devotees, that is the arrangement of Krishna. We see many great devotees, they have different kinds of obstacles. Does that mean that Krishna is thinking to give obstacles, adversities to devotees more purifying than the other situations? Will we meet the new devotees, new people who will preach, and then if we say like this, then they become very much afraid. They said they cannot practice Krishna consciousness. How can we explain to the new people how to confront these obstacles?
We don't explain these things to the new people.
我们不给新人解释这样的事情。
We just tell them eat prasadam, chant and dance.
我们只告诉他们吃 prasadam, 唱诵并且跳舞。
All your problems will be solved.
你所有的问题都可以得到解决。
We don't want to tell them these things.
我们不想告诉他们这些东西。
那如果他们遇到了痛苦，他们说我在骗人。你说亏得那么好的命，我那么多痛苦。
But then they meet some obstacle, they would say, "You are cheating me, cheating us."
You have to tell them actually you're meant to suffer much more, but Krishna reduced the suffering.
你应该告诉他们，本来你应该遭受更多的痛苦，但是 Krishna 已经大大减少了你的痛苦。
The devotee cut their finger, and Prabhupada said, "You were meant to be stabbed to death." You just got a cut finger. See, Krishna changed the karma because you've become a devotee.
奉献者割了自己的手指头，啪啪就会说，本来你应该被刺死，被刀给刺死，但是现在 Krishna 已经把你这个减少了很多，只是割破了你的手指头而已。
Krishna is very merciful.
Krishna 非常的仁慈。
We should see how merciful Lord Krishna is. He's given us so much.
我们应该看到 Krishna 是多么的仁慈，他给了我们这么多。
But we're not very grateful. We're the ungrateful people. We say, "Oh, you didn't give me this, you didn't give me."
但是我们非常的不知道感恩，我们总是在抱怨，哦，你没给我这个，那个也没给我。
See what Krishna has given you.
看看 Krishna 给了你什么吧。
Actually, if we did not have Krishna, where would we be? We would be really in a miserable position.
要是如果没有 Krishna 的话，我们会在什么地方？我们会在非常非常痛苦的处境之中。
So devotee sees the mercy of Krishna.
所以奉献者应该看到 Krishna 的仁慈。
Okay.
And online, one question from Taruni is asking: obeisances to you, Gurudev. Under the present internet regulations situation, what shall we do in our daily practice?
Well, you can still associate with the devotees. Maybe you can't associate with so many devotees, but at least you can associate with a smaller group of devotees.
Taruni 的问题说，顶拜您姑爹面对咱们现在的整顿网络的这个大环境下，我们日常休息应该怎么做？姑马哈拉就回答说，你可以还是跟奉献者们一起联谊，可能不能跟很多的奉献者联谊，可以跟少数几个奉献者一起联谊。
Have to make the best of a bad bargain.
应该把最糟糕的情况利用到最好的程度。
You'll find Krishna will give us the intelligence how to adjust things.
Krishna 会给我们智性来调整。
But just be determined that whatever happens, I'm never going to give up Krishna.
但应该做好准备，无论发生什么情况，我永远不会放弃 Krishna.
Okay, Hare Krishna.Srila Prabhupada ki.
Jai.
Go back to Vrinda ki.
Jai.